Thank you very much indeed. What a delight to be here. It really is a pleasure. Let me tell you a little bit about this process. First of all, I was reminded earlier on of a quotation from the great Northern Irish poet John Hewitt. John Hewitt has been quoted several times by Michael Longley as having said, memorably, if you go into the poetry business, it's nobody's fault but your own. Worth thinking about. It's nobody's fault but your own. You cannot expect anything. In fact, put another way, you can expect nothing. One can barely expect anyone to read one's poem, and that's in anticipation of it being published. One may not expect it to be published, and then if it happens to be published, one may certainly not expect anyone to read it. So the expectations are low, and it's one of the reasons why I was thrilled to have this opportunity to read, as we were hearing, a great range of poems. Why did I decide to read all of them? Well, I was reminded of a competition years ago in Northern Ireland, which was open to one and all. I believe it was open to everyone and anyone from 9 to 90 or beyond. And the poem I thought was most effective on that occasion was a poem of one line, which I've quoted a few times over the years, but the poem was called The Tortoise. And the poem went, "The tortoise goes movie, movie." That's M-O-V-E-Y, M-O-V-E-Y, that's it. The tortoise goes movie, movie, which is a spectacular description of a tortoise, right? Now, my sense is that there's every chance that a first reader, a professional reader, as it were, of that poem, just to put it to one side. And indeed, on that night, a woman came up to me after I announced the decision and said, "How could you have done such a thing? This child is 9. He can barely write his own name. And here you've given him first prize in this poetry competition. What are you thinking?" Well, I suppose what I'm thinking, of course, always is that poetry has that fantastic capacity to come from nowhere, to come when you least expect it, and to give one a jolt, to set one back, to make one revise one's sense of how things are in the world. And so I spent about a month reading these poems, a few here, a few there, sifting them, winnowing them, and we came down, I came down to this. Get a little roof there.